We invested 310 years of slave labor, 310 years, every day of which your and my mother and father worked for nothing.
Malcolm X's unyielding search for truth leads him to a broader understanding of the universal message of Islam.
There is a cultural connection that we're finding between slavery and the rise of Islam.
The slave trade saw the arrival of millions of Muslims from Africa to the New World.
These people were not just common people who were captured, they were literally scholars.
The relationship between Islam and people of African descent, we can go back to the very beginning of the mission of the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, where we know that many of his companions were of African descent.
The relation between African Americans, between Africans and Islam, goes back a long, long way. Back to the early years of Islam, back to the Prophet Muhammad in Mecca some 1400 years ago. Muslims consider Muhammad not only the prophet of Islam, but also the example by which to lead one's life. Muhammad was born in Mecca in 570. He was orphaned at a young age. He tended sheep in his youth, and as he grew older, he became known for his truthfulness, generosity, wisdom, and sincerity. Muhammad lived among people who worshipped idols, killed their infant daughters, practiced slavery, and were corrupt to an extreme. Muslims believe that God sent Muhammad as a messenger, a reformer, to them and to all of humanity.
Muhammad ibn Abdullah, peace be upon him, was the last of a long series of prophets. At the age of 40, Prophet Muhammad received revelation from the angel Gabriel, and followed basically the same system of monotheism and the golden rule and living a good life that all of the prophets of monotheism have followed.
Muhammad shared God's message of peace and love with his people. With the exception of a few, most of the people of Mecca rejected his call to worship one God. Muhammad and his followers became the subjects of bitter persecution. When the situation in Mecca became intolerable for the early Muslims, Muhammad sent some of his followers to seek refuge from the king of Abyssinia, a good and wise man known for his faith and justice. There, among Africans and for the first time in history, Muslims found peace and the freedom to practice Islam openly.
The African Christian emperor of Abyssinia, known as Ashama, his title was the Negus, or Najashi, and he gave them sanctuary, he gave them a place to stay, and he protected them. And what is significant about this is that really it is the first interfaith coming together between the Arabian Peninsula and the African continent. People who are tortured and oppressed are given sanctuary by a believer in God.
The relationship between Islam and people of African descent or Africa, we can go back to the very beginning of the mission of the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, where we know that many of his companions were of African descent. The most prominent amongst them probably was Bilal.
Bilal was an educated man from Abyssinia who had been enslaved in Mecca. His master was a wealthy trader who hated the Muslims and particularly hated Muhammad. He was furious when Bilal accepted Islam.
They take him, beat Bilal, flog him, and begin to put stones on his chest in the hot desert sun, asking him to renounce his belief now in one God. While Bilal is being tortured for the truth, the companions of the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salam gather accumulate their wealth, some of the wealthy among them, and attempt to purchase Bilal before he is tortured to death.
Bilal was tortured almost to the point of death, yet he did not renounce his belief. The early Muslims gathered their wealth and bought Bilal's freedom. A sign to other slaves that there is hope, that there are people who will sacrifice their wealth and themselves to secure the rights of those who are oppressed.
The Prophet Muhammad said, anyone who frees a slave, he will be like this with me in paradise. And so, although Islam recognizes the existence of slavery, it applies also the deterrent from taking slaves and the encouragement to emancipate slaves.